Hello everyone, I am Chandrakant Rathod, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to start a new topic, that is Introduction to Thermodynamics. Coming to the learning outcomes, at the end of the today's lecture, student will be able to understand what are the different types of systems and its property. So coming to the content, the following topic will be discussed in this video lecture. That is Introduction to Thermodynamics, types of thermodynamics system and properties of the system. So coming to the introduction of the system, thermodynamic system, thermodynamic is a branch of science which deals with the energy transfer and its effect on the state of the system. It explains the interaction between heat, work and other physical properties such as pressure, volume and temperature of the working substance. The observations and common experience have been formulated into the law of thermodynamics. The law and concepts are important in the innovative design, development and improvement of the various engineering processes and equipment, especially in the field of energy utilization. The application of thermodynamics law and principles are found in many engineering fields such as internal combustion engine, gas turbine, air conditioning, gas dynamics, jet propulsion, steam and nuclear power plants and energy conversion devices. So first we are going to discuss what is the meaning of the system and what are the boundary, what are the universe we are going to discuss and what is the surroundings. So first we are going to consider what is the system. It is the region in a space upon which a study is focused or concentrated. So let us consider here the system is our universe. In that one we are going to select a part so that we are going to study on that one. So for example, we are going to consider the room as a system. So out of this room, that is the universe we are going to consider. So coming to the surrounding, anything external to the system is known as surrounding. So as we know that we are considered the room as the concentrated area to be studied, and out of that one, external to this room, we are going to consider the surrounding. So coming to the boundary, it is the separation between system and the surrounding. So boundary may be a rigid or flexible. So as we are discussing here that, so we are considering the room as a system. So external to the system, this room, we are going to consider the surrounding. So whatever the wall which we are constructed in between the system and the surrounding, that is called the boundary. So we can consider here the boundary is a rigid one. So wall is the rigid, so that for that one we are going to consider this as a rigid boundary. So coming to the types of thermodynamic system, the system is a prescribed region of space or finite quantity of matter. It is surrounded by an envelope called the boundary, which may be imaginary surface or enclosing some matter. The boundary may be fixed or it may be movable when a system containing a gas is compressed or expanded. The different types of system which are of the engineering interest are as follow. So first we are going to consider the closed system. What is mean by closed system? No mass crosses but energy crosses the boundary of the system. We are going to see in detail what is the closed system afterwards. And open system, so mass and energy crosses the boundary of the system. Here also we are going to consider afterwards, we are going to explain in detail about the open system. And isolated system, no mass and energy crosses the boundary of the system. And another one is the adiabatic system. And last one is the homogeneous and heterogeneous system. So now we are going to see the in detail about the closed system. If the boundary of the system is impervious to the flow of matter, it is called as an closed system. The system consists of the gas confined between cylinder and the piston. Although the heat and work may cross the boundary and volume of the system may change owing to the motion of the piston, the system closed system since no mass crosses the boundary. For example, tea kettle, radiator of the automobile, refrigerant in a refrigerator, pressure cooker, IC engine during compression and expansion stroke. Coming to the open system, if the matter flows into or out of the system is considered to be open system. In this system, heat, work, and matter may cross the boundary of the system, and net amount of work within the system may vary with the time. So, example for the open systems are air compressor, centrifugal pump, turbine, carburetor, evaporator, etc. So, coming to the isolated system, if there is no energy transfer between the system and its surroundings, a system is said to be an isolated system. Example, universe is the best example for the isolated system. And another practical or real life example is thermo flask. So in that one, thermo flask is the isolated system. Here, when we fill the hot liquid or a cold liquid, so some energy will going to loss in this system after long time. Then coming to the adiabatic system. An adiabatic system is one which is thermally insulated from its surrounding. It can exchange work with its surroundings. If it does not, then it becomes an isolated system. So coming to the homogeneous system, a system which consists of single phase is called homogeneous system. Example, mixture of air and water vapor. Coming to the heterogeneous system, a system which consists of two or more phases is called heterogeneous system. Example for the heterogeneous system is water plus steam, ice plus water, and water plus oil. We're going to consider the example for the heterogeneous system. So here we are considering the phase. Then what is mean by phase, we're going to discuss here now. A phase is a quantity of matter which is homogeneous throughout in the chemical composition and physical structure. So coming to the properties of the system. So we're going to discuss the different properties of the system. Now, the thermodynamic equilibrium state of the thermodynamic system at a particular time is defined as by observable characteristics called the state variable. Thermodynamics coordinates, state parameters are simple properties. Properties are a function of the state of the system only. Hence, they do not depend on the history of the system or the property of the fixed only by the end state of the system. Or in other words, all properties are the point function. So we're going to consider here the important properties of the system are as follow: intensive property, extensive property. So coming to the intensive property, intensive property do not depend on the mass of the system. For example, temperature, pressure, and density do not depend on the mass of the system. An intensive property may be defined as a point function since it has a finite value when the size of the system's surroundings, the point approaches zero. Intensive property defines intensive state of the system. Examples are temperature, pressure, and density. So coming to the extensive property, the property which depends on the size of the system, such as length, volume, and energy, are the extensive property. The ratio of the intensive property to the mass is called the specific volume of the property. So example for the extensive properties are volume, surface tension, enthalpy, entropy, potential energy, etc. So coming to the thermodynamic equilibrium, the temperature of the system does not change with the time and has some value at all the system, that is called the thermodynamic equilibrium. So coming to the mechanical equilibrium, there is no unbalanced forces within the system or between the surroundings. The pressure in the system is same at all point and do not change with respect to the time. So that is called the mechanical equilibrium. So coming to the chemical equilibrium, no chemical reaction takes place in the system and the chemical position which is same throughout the system do not vary with the time. So now please think that what is mean by temperature and the pressure. Now, I am going to define that. What is mean by temperature? The temperature is a thermal state of a body which distinguishes a hot body from a cold body. It gives an indication of the relative heat condition between the substance and the and determines the ability of one substance to transfer heat voluntarily to another substance at lower temperature. And it is this temperature is measured in degree Celsius. Example, thermometer, it means measures ordinary temperature. Pyrometers, it measures the high temperature. So coming to the pressure of the system is the force exerted by the system on unit area of boundary. So these are the some references which are used for the this lecture, that is thermodynamics by Dumkundwar and Kodandaraman, Dhanpatraya publication. Thermal engineering by R.K. Rajput, that is Lakshmi Publication Private Limited. Basic thermodynamics, Dr. M.K. Murlidharan, Subhash Store, Book Corner Publication. Thank you.